Well, number nine survives, but it wasn't easy for Georgetown. The Hoyas win at West Virginia by one on a Jesse Sapp three and a Patrick Ewing block as the buzzer sounds on Deshaun Butler. It was ruled a legal block.
This season, the Minis posted a combined total of 65 goals and 23 assists, along with 223 ground balls.
Decided to come back for his senior season. Hibbert will be a candidate for that Player of the Year honor while almost certainly improving his draft status. Yes, Hibbert can be a game changer inside.
Senior college basketball player died last night after collapsing during halftime of a game at Hill College in Hillsboro. Hillsboro police say Mike DeRibby, a player with Grayson County College, collapsed in the locker room. The 18-year-old freshman from Fort Bend was pronounced dead at Hill Regional Hospital less than an hour
later. A faulty heart valve was to blame, one that could have been detected with an electrocardiogram, an EKG.
He was a master swimmer who had a heart attack while competing in the 1,500-meter event.
His 19-year-old New York Rangers prospect Alexei Cherepanov has died during a game in the Russian Continental League today. The Omsk forward collapsed at the bench near the end of their game today on the road in Chekhov. Medical personnel tried to revive him after his heart had stopped but were unsuccessful in their attempts. Last year, he was the sixth leading scorer for Omsk and helped lead Russia to a bronze medal at the 2008 World Junior Championship. He was the Rangers' first-round choice, 17th overall in the 2007 NHL entry draft. Alexei Cherepanov, dead at the age of 19.
Recently, one of America's elite distance runners stumbled off the course at the Olympic Trials Marathon in New York. He died after attempts at resuscitation.
Less than a half hour into the marathon that Ryan Hall would win, Alicia Shea got a call on her cell phone. Her husband had collapsed at the 5-mile mark. She rushed to his bedside at the hospital, but doctors were unable to restart his heart. Ryan Shea had passed away at 28.
I just lay there with him and kept waiting. I just had my hands over his heart because I knew he was going to start breathing again. So that was obviously a very painful process. I mean, I didn't want to leave the room because I thought he was going to be okay.
An autopsy of Shea revealed an enlarged heart.
Reggie White, a very special man, and everybody in the football world and fans everywhere just stunned and shocked yesterday to the extent that it was almost not believable. Reggie White, at the age of 43, dying at his home. 198 sacks, was named the NFL's Defensive Player of the Year twice, and was chosen for 13 Pro Bowls. An extraordinary man both on and off the field, Reggie White has left an indelible mark.
Could it happen? Wasn't he too young? We know that heart disease is the leading cause of death for both men and women, but doesn't it strike in later years? Well, the fact is close to 75,000 heart attacks occur in people under the age of 40 every year. And what you know about it can make a big difference.
Every year, six NCAA student athletes die due to sudden cardiac death.
According to a cardiologist who says that the signs of the disease, commonly known as athlete's heart, are often fatal.
But the irony here is that he had no symptoms. He virtually had no symptoms. He never had chest pain. He He never had shortness of breath.
Well, it's called hypertrophic cardiomyopathy. It's the leading cause of death among athletes under the age of 30.
But the disease can be caught early on with a simple heart scan. And
the single leading cause of death in student athletes is sudden cardiac arrest.
Through education of sudden cardiac arrest, we can raise awareness to help prevent it.
It affects everyone, but we have the ability to change this.
Raise awareness. Know your family history. Know the importance of proper dieting. Know the benefits of getting an EKG.